The outside structure is already finished, and this week the seats and scoreboard are going in. Now, opening day, as Fred mentioned, is April 11th. The stadium builders have a big incentive to finish on time. They would be fined $45,000 for every day that deadline is not met. 27,000 season tickets have already been sold, and the Giants predict a near sellout crowd for nearly every game next year. And you probably have your favorite memories of Candlestick. So does columnist Chuck Nevious, and he'll share those a bit later on the Noon News.
I have seen that piece. It is worth sticking around for.
Really,
it's absolutely
terrific.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Still to come here on the Noon News, two of the major
baby to the ballpark known as the Stick for so many years. Manuel Ramos is out there at Candlestick for the fond farewell. Manny?
Well, Ken, if you're a Giants fan like me and you have to work today, there's no better place to do your job than at Candlestick Park. Behind me, some of the fans who were lucky enough to get the day off and get a ticket to this game. With 61,000 people packing into Candlestick, there will be more fans here than on that first day, back in April of 1960. A seat back then was 98 cents. Scalp tickets for this game are going for a couple of $100. The experience is priceless for a longtime Giants fan.
To me, it's not windy, it's not cold.
What is it?
Beautiful.
For us, aside from this year, there really hasn't been too many cold nights because we sit on the third base side and leave the wind and the cold to the first baseline.
I'm going to miss it a lot. I've been coming here since I was 4 years old with my parents and over 30 years of memories. And it's going to be a lot, you know, tears are going to flow at the end of the game, but looking forward to it.
The Giants are prepared for fans who might get carried away and try to carry away some souvenirs. Home plate was packed into the ground with some added pressure to make it tough to steal. Now, today is a little bit like that day you go get a haircut. That day, your hair never looks better, of course. And today, as the Giants are saying goodbye to Candlestick, the weather is perfect. I'm Manuel Ramos in San Francisco.
I think I had a lot more hair in 1959. I'm not sure about you, Manny, but thanks for that report. Well, a lot of popular characters from Candlestick's past are on hand for today's last game. Last night seemed to be reserved for those on the Giants fans' least popular list. Nobody walks like that. Former Dodgers manager Tommy Lasorda received the usual warm San Francisco welcome. He returned the favor by offering an off-key rendition of Take Me Out to the Ball Game. And hey, look who returned from oblivion to throw out the first pitch.
Tonight, I feel like the luckiest crab on the face of the earth. You guys proved you remembered. And I hate you too.
Yes, the beloved Crazy Crab, who had a short gig as the Giants mascot in the mid-1980s.
Well, today will be especially memorable for those who have played an active role on the team over the years. Doug Murphy is standing by live at the Stick with reaction from some current and former players. Hi, Doug.
Hi there. Can you believe it? 40 years, and it all comes down to this, 9 more innings. You know, there have been thousands of games played here by thousands of players. And really, millions of fans have come in, and there's a lifetime of memories here. And we sampled a few of them.
Well, my fondest memory was probably my very first hit bat in the big leagues. I was with the Braves, and I got my first, you know, big league hit here off Juan Marichal, a little bleeder, a little dribbler down third baseline.
You'll take it, though.
Oh, yeah. I was 19 years old, and a guy I'd watched on TV many, many times. That one and probably the Brian Johnson home run that we end up, you know, going to the playoffs.
Anything that anybody ever said about it, whether it be the cold or the wind, it was a little bit more than what they explained it or described it as.
As we get blown over.
Yeah, exactly. There's really no, until you've been through it for a whole season or two and been out here for night games and day games, you really don't get a feel for it.
My greatest moment here at the Stick was the comeback day after being diagnosed with cancer, and then 10 months later to be standing on the mound here in Candlestick Park and, you know, with some 34,000 fans cheering you on and the support of the community, it was just an overwhelming feeling.
Best memory of Candlestick is watching two back-to-back no-hitters here, like Gaylord Perry threw the night before and Raymond Washburn, the St. Louis Cardinals, threw the next day. So that was memorable things about Candlestick. The other one was the Beatles, and we had the Rolling Stones here, and we had a lot of concerts here, we had the fights here. So this place brings back a lot of good old memories.
You know, I always knew that Murph was a Rolling Stone fan. You could really tell it. I think my biggest memory would be that 82 Joe Morgan home run that eliminated the Dodgers from playoff contention that year. It happened October the 3rd. It was a wonderful day if you dislike the Dodgers like so many Giant fans do. Well, other than being last day, as Manny said a bit ago, everything is typical. Full house out here today, 62,000. Game time temperature, probably 85. That's the story here at the Stick for the last time. I'm Doug Murphy. Back
to you. That's a nice salute. Goodbye. Thank you, Doug.
Well, it was a serious accident in...
Now, over the years, there have been so many great memories at the Stick. Here's Chuck Devious now to show us some moments we'll never forget.
The story of Candlestick Park begins right here in the box seats right next to the Giants' dugout. The date was April 12, 1960, opening day. This box was full of dignitaries. But you have to say that the people who were here that day would have a tough time recognizing Candlestick Park in its current configuration.
And what turned out to be an exception, for the next 39 years, the day dawned clear and sunny, and a packed house filled the new Candlestick Park. Box seats were filled with dignitaries. Ty Cobb showed up. And the biggest star of them all, Richard Milhouse Nixon, the President of the United States, came to throw out the first pitch. He proclaimed it the finest ballpark in the United States. You never could trust him. The second year the park was open, Candlestick hosted the All-Star Game. The date was July 11, 1961. Giants right-hander Stu Miller delighted the crowd when he came out in the bottom of the ninth to put out the fires. As he took his stretch, he was blown forward. The umpire called a balk. Miller has always insisted the breeze didn't affect him that much, but his argument has been blown away and the Candlestick wins. The wins at Candlestick became famous. They were more than a presence. They were a force. Teams hated to play here. There was no such thing as a routine fly ball. Pete Rose once said, when a pop-up went up, usually guys would yell, "I got it." At Candlestick, they'd yell, "Who wants it?" There's nothing special about the Candlestick infield. It's made of dirt. Bases are 90 feet apart. But on October 16th, 1962, the Giants came to this spot right here, and they buried heartbreak. You know the story by now. The 1962 World Series, bottom of the ninth. Yankees ahead of the Giants, 1-0. Matty Alou on third base. Willie Mays on second. Willie McCovey up at bat. There's a story that Bobby Richardson, the Yankee second baseman, moved two steps to his left to say something to an umpire just before McCovey swung. If only Richardson hadn't moved over. If only McCovey's hit had been a little higher. If.
There's a liner straight to Richardson. The ball game is over and the World Series is over. Willie McCovey hit it like a bullet.
Giants fans have always rooted for two teams, the Giants and who was ever playing the Dodgers. So if you're a real Giants fan, you remember October 3rd, 1982. And you remember this post over the right field wall. The Giants season was over by then. They still had a chance to spoil things for the Dodgers. A sold-out crowd watched Joe Morgan's three-run home run off Terry Forrester in the seventh inning beat Los Angeles 5-3 to give the National League West title to Atlanta by one game. The Giants weren't going to the postseason, but neither were the Dodgers. And that was good enough.
Morgan bounced it high and deep right field. Way back goes Monday to the fence. It is gone. Home run, Joe Morgan. And the Giants lead the Dodgers 5-2.
By 1989, people began to wonder if Candlestick was cursed. Maybe the Giants would never make it to the World Series. That year, Roger Craig and his Hum Babies staged an unbelievable run in the National League West. And on October 9th, 1989, Will Clark, standing right here at this plate, took his bat back and sent the Giants to the World Series.
We should have figured it would come down to this. Will Clark with a chance to win it.
Giants had lots of stars that year. Kevin Mitchell was MVP, and Rick Rushell and Scott Goreltz anchored the pitching staff. But Will Clark was a fan favorite. In what's been called the most dramatic at-bat in Candlestick history, Clark fouled off two fastballs for Mitch Williams, then lined a single up the middle for a 2-1 lead. That held up to clinch the game, send the Giants to the World Series for the first time in 27 years. On October 17, 1989, it was about 5:07 in the afternoon. The two teams in the World Series were taking batting practice. Up here in Section 51, the gentleman in seat 24 leaned back. Suddenly, the earth moved. He looked down between his shoes to see what had happened. The stadium had split. He could see nothing but air for 200 feet straight down.
Ask your cooperation by remaining in your seats.
Come on, let's go! The earthquake before the third game of the 1989 World Series may have been one of the most unexpected moments in sports. And it was all the more stunning because it was on national television. The games were delayed for 10 days. When they resumed, all the fire had gone out of the series. The Oakland A's won in four games, but in their clubhouse afterwards, they didn't even bother to spray champagne. He used to call this tunnel the tunnel of misery. Players were brought down here in the dugout, in the clubhouse. Sometimes they were told they were traded. Sometimes they were told they were released. This will be different. When baseball players go down this tunnel for the last time, it'll be the end of professional baseball at Candlestick Park. There was never a park like Candlestick Park. There'll never be another one. Thank God.
For the new news, I'm Chuck Nevious.
What a great piece, wasn't it?
Many memories.
Listen to this. You want to know some of the prices from back in 1960 when the Giants first got here? The bleacher seats were 90 cents a piece.
Wow.
Parking, 75 cents. Beer, 40 cents. Hot dogs, 30 cents. Popcorn, 15 cents. Peanuts, 15 cents.
Yeah, and look at the prices now.
Yeah, I know. Boy, those were the days, huh?
It's been a great time. Yeah, it sure was. Thank you for watching. Dennis and Leslie will be here with a 10 o'clock.
Hornet bounces high and deep right field. Way back goes Monday. The fence is gone. Home run, Joe Morgan.
They can't believe it touched it. They do in San Francisco.
I will remember you.
The Giants have won the pennant.
Will you remember me? Don't let your
decades, over 56 million fans have walked through the turnstiles to root for San Francisco's team. A shiny new home will be ready next season, but today the old ballpark is dressed up and ready for one last dance. The Giants play their final game at Candlestick Park next. Perfect day for a party, and we got a good one. The Giants and the Dodgers shut the door on the Candlestick Park forever, and a sellout crowd is set for an afternoon of memories. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Glenn Kuiper, and welcome to Candlestick Park and a very special edition of the CHW Giants pregame report. Now, come next April, the only ballpark around here that anybody's going to want to talk about is Pacific Bell Park, but today, that honor goes to the Stick. And, you know, last night these two teams played.
Well, maybe the most entertaining part of the evening was the famous Tommy Lasorda walk. Tommy milked it like only he can. Also, the Crazy Crab made his first appearance at the Stick since 1984. And guess what? Giants fans still want nothing to do with the Crab. Now, once the game started, it was the Giants' night from the beginning. In the first inning, Barry Bonds ripped a two-run shot off Kevin Brown to give San Francisco a 2-0 lead. In the third, the Giants loaded the bases with two outs when J.T. Snow, huge base hit, Miller and Bond scored to make it 4-0. It was 4-1 in the eighth when Jeff Kent went to right center field, 23rd home run and 99th RBI on the year, and the Giants led 5-1. Now they would need all those runs. The Dodgers loaded the bases with one out in the ninth, but Bronswell Patrick retired Gary Sheffield on a strikeout and then Eric Karros on a fly ball to right. First career save for Patrick as the Giants finally beat Kevin Brown, and Giants fans drove into the night happy. Final score in the final night game ever at the Stick, the Giants 5 and the Dodgers 1.
Well, joining us again today on the Giants pregame report is Gary Radnich from KRON Sports and also KNBI Radio. And Gary, I know you were here early, and so was I. And, you know, I got a feeling right from the start, as soon as I pulled in, that this was a very special day in San Francisco.
Yeah, most certainly was, Glenn. And I'll tell you, my heartstrings were tugged at a little bit around 9 o'clock. I had just left KNBR after interviewing the great crooner, Eddie Fisher, in regards to his marriages to Elizabeth Taylor, Debbie Reynolds, and Connie Stevens. And I pulled in along the bleacher area where people buy their tickets, and there were about 100 people asking, are there any bleacher seats on sale today? I had to say no, and it's pretty sad because this is a day for the fans. We talked about this last night. With the rare exception, I think these players, they're moving on with their lives. They didn't grow up in this ballpark. It's a different story. But these fans, this day belongs to them, and there were at least 100 people with long faces when I said, if you don't have a ticket, folks, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no question. It is a day for the fans and not the players. But you've got a chance to talk to a lot of people this morning about what Candlestick Park is all about, and it's amazing. Stories that you thought you've heard them all, but you get new ones.
Well, my favorite, Glenn, of all the people we talked to, we did about 3 hours on the radio this morning, is a man who came up with a picture of himself and Bill Lasky, the old Giant pitcher from 1984. 1984, that's 15 years ago. And with all due respect to Bill Lasky, you know, he's not Mays or McCovey or Barry Bonds. And the man said, do you think there's any way? I've been waiting all this time to have Bill Lasky sign my photo, so I'm still working on that, hoping to hook that gentleman up. But that's what this day is about, to forget all the cynicism and those of us in the media who feel we have to pick and find fault. Today is to think and think back and say, wow, 40 years for many of us, our first look at Major League Baseball right here at Candlestick.
Yeah, I agree, Gary. Let's just sit back and enjoy this. Why not? Now, when we come back to the CHW Giants pregame report, we'll check in with Rod Brooks, and also Gary Radnich will sit down with one of the all-time favorites here at the Stick, Roger Craig. It is down to zero, folks, the final game ever at the Stick.
Giants pregame report is brought to you by Catholic Healthcare West, the Bay Area leader in sports medicine.
This is good. Oh, this is going to be cool.
You're wrong.
No, this is great.
Milt, where are you going?
Mitch.
Mitch, or
yep.
Whatever.
Yeah.
This is the celebrity golf class.
Yeah.
For celebrities only. Real celebrities.
I told you I didn't like this. Next, he's going to call security or something.
Security!
Check out some of the stars who did get to play in this special edition of Hooked on Golf. Michael Jordan leads the field at the Joe Morgan Celebrity Golf Classic, presented by your Northern California Toyota dealers. Monday night at 9, only on Fox Sportsnet Bay Area. Now for a CHW sports tip.
Knee injuries are very common, but how do you know if your knee requires more than just rest and ice? Damage to bones, ligaments, and cartilage can occur during twisting, cutting, and impact activities. Symptoms such as swelling, popping, locking, or pain with weight bearing may represent a more significant injury. An examination by your sports medicine physician will determine proper treatment and prevent further injury.
This health moment brought to you by the doctors and hospitals of CHW and their centers for sports medicine.
Smaller electrodes, more power. More electrodes, faster starts. Different electrodes.
Tired of spark plugs with crazy gimmicks? Get the plug with the feature that counts. One perfect spark. Presenting the Autolite Platinum Pro. It's 30% more durable with platinum to platinum firing for a spark that lasts after gimmicks burn out. The Autolite Platinum Pro. It's one perfect spark guaranteed. Ask for your free $5 Home Depot gift certificate from Autolite.
Fox Sportsnet Bay Area is now the exclusive home of San Jose Sharks hockey.
check us out all season long for 60 games worth of excitement right through the playoffs. Saturday, October 2nd is opening night as the Sharks try to douse the Calgary Flames. The excitement continues on Thursday, October 7th with a battle against the Edmonton Oilers. Then on Saturday, October 9th, the Sharks face off against the Stanley Cup champion, Dallas Stars. The only place to watch Sharks excitement this season is on Fox Sportsnet Bay Area.
1-2 pitch. Morin fouls it high and deep right field. Way back goes Monday to the fence. It is gone! Home run, Joe Morgan! And the Giants lead the Dodgers 5-2.
Well, Tommy Lasorda may have shed a few tears after that Joe Morgan home run. Now my pregame show co-host Rod Brooks has it covered in case anybody gets a little emotional this afternoon. Rod?
Thank you very much, Glenn. You know, I've had a lot of people tell me that they won't shed a tear once Candlestick Park is gone, and quite frankly, I don't believe it one bit. There have been a lot of memories around this place, and it's going to be hard to walk out of Candlestick after the Giants hopefully beat the Dodgers without shedding a tear. If you are the sentimental type, such as myself, a softie, we've got something to help you dry those tears up. Tissues. We try to be nice here at Fox Sports Net Bay Area, as you can see, Fox Sports Net, to help wipe away the tears on the final day at the stick. Let's face it, this has been a beautiful place for baseball memories and a great place to watch baseball. Never mind the cold. I don't think there's going to be one person to walk away without a couple of tears streaming down their cheeks. If that's you, we've got something to help you out. Glenn, back to you.
All right, thanks a lot, Rod. Now, when you look around Candlestick Park today, you're going to get a chance to see many of the former great players and managers. And let's check in with Gary Radnich right now, who is standing by with the original Hum Baby, Roger Craig.
Thank you very much, Glenn. If you've been around the Giants in Candlestick Park for a while, you well remember the mid-1980s, baseball dying in San Francisco. Roger Craig and Al Rosen came in, and before you know it, 87 and 89, they're going to the postseason. Welcome back, Roger. You have been a stranger of sorts here at Candlestick. Why?
Well, you know, I live in San Diego. We have a place down in Hilton Head, South Carolina, and I spend a lot of time with the family and play a lot of golf, and I just thought I'd best stay away, because if I do come back, you know, you get the adrenaline going again, and I enjoy my retirement. I really don't have the thoughts of coming back to baseball, but
so you made a clean break then?
Yes, I did. I always said I could walk away and go on to a new life. There's another life besides baseball, but baseball was great. The 7 years I spent here were my best in baseball. I enjoyed it so much, and we had some great years, and the fans were just, and the people here even today are just, they're like the old Brooklyn Dodger fans. They don't forget.
Yeah. To show how long Roger has been away, though, we were laughing. He asked, who are these fellas in uniform? I said, these are the ball dudes who get the foul balls, and you said?
I said, when I was here, they were 16 years old. I've been away that long.
Yeah, we've gone in a different direction. We'll take you back to 1989, when the Giants make it to the World Series. Your memory of that stretch run. Here we go against the Cubbies.
Throws to Sandberg, and the pitch is grounded to second
base.
Well,
you know, we just had, there's the guy you want the ball to hit to in the bottom of the ninth inning with two outs. Hit the ball to Robbie Thompson, because he wanted it, and he never missed it. That was just an unbelievable year. We had so many guys that participated and did such a good job coming down the stretch, and you know, my coaches did a great job, and Al Rosen supplied me with the players that we needed the last couple of months of the season, and it was just a great year for us. I'll never forget that year.
Not to get heavy on a pregame show here celebrating the last day at Candlestick Park, but from what you hear and understand about the game today, would you be comfortable managing in today's environment?
It would be tough. I know it was tough when I managed, but it nowadays where the greed is there, you know, there's no loyalty. The guy jumped from club to club, and it's just tough to me. It's tough to motivate them enough when you've got to play 162 games and 30 games in spring training. And but you know, there's so many things that goes on there. The generations they keep getting younger and want to do things on their own, and so it makes it really tough for a manager. And I feel for Dusty Baker and all that. He's done a great job here, and Dusty was one of my coaches for a long time, but it's a lot tougher to manage now even than when I was here.
You pitched as a Met and managed at Candlestick. Do you enjoy the windy, wide-open environment?
I used to tell my players, let's use this to our advantage. I know you've heard this before, but we did. You know, you come out here at batting practice, and the opposing team would take batting practice, and they walk by the cage, and they said, how do you guys stand it? And, you know, they said, let's play our three games and get out of here. And But, you know, we'd go back east and play in the East Coast with the high humidity and hot weather and come back here. It's like being in an air-conditioned ballpark. So I think we used it to our advantage, and we knew the wind and played pretty well here.
All right. Well, that ranch is treating you good in San Diego. You look great, Roger, and no worries about a hit and run or what reliever to bring in. Life's treating you good, and thanks for spending a few minutes.
Hey, Gary, thank you very much.
All right. That's Roger Craig. One more time, baseball in a bad way, mid-1980s. Craig and Rosen take over, and the Giant franchise been rolling most ever since. We'll go back to Glenn Kuiper.
All right, thanks, Gary. And boy, is it great to see the original hum baby, Roger Craig. Well, we are just minutes away from the final baseball game ever here at Candlestick Park. It is, of course, the Giants and the Dodgers. Still to come, Val Diamond and members of the Grateful Dead. But up next, an updated look at the Giants' new home, Pacific Bell Park.
If you're ready to lose weight, muscle up, and get back into shape, I've got a free video you're gonna love.
Introducing a winning fitness strategy.
You gotta eat healthy, drink plenty of water, and most importantly, strength train with Bowflex.
Strength training adds muscle. Not only does your shape look better, you actually increase your metabolism, so you end up burning more calories.
Strength training these days isn't just for men. It's great for women, too. And Bowflex is designed for both. It's even been called the best home gym by Fitness Magazine.
Use as little as 5 pounds to more than 400 pounds of resistance. Follow our 6-week fast fat loss program or create your own from over 60 different health club quality exercises.
Bowflex is easy to own and it fits in any room in your house. It comes with a 6-week guarantee on results and you can finance it with no money down and payments as low as $33 per month. Hey, I'm 41 and I'm in the best shape of my life. And I can tell you, Bowflex really does work.
For a free video and brochure on the machine that can help you get into great shape at any age, call right now.
Now for a CHW sports tip.
With the increased emphasis on winning, many athletes feel that more exercise is better, but this can lead to overuse injuries. Fatigue, depression, and worsening performance can be signs that you are overtraining. Stress fractures are often the result. Recovery time is just as important as the exercise itself. If you have questions, consult a sports medicine physician.
This health moment brought to you by the doctors and hospitals of CHW and their centers for sports medicine.
I hate dings in the door. I have this one terrible one. Some fool comes along out of the grocery store and just bangs right in the side. And then, of course, he's looking around. Nobody else can see him but me. He's banged, and I have this huge dent. But my owner can't always get to him, you know, right away to get him fixed. But I think she tries to make up for it. She gives me Chevron Supreme with Teclon because I'm a car designed for high-octane gas.
No premium outperforms Chevron Supreme with Teclon. Chevron, simply smarter.
Oh, and 2, Wagoner delivers. Mays hits it into left field. There goes number 3,000. Willie Mays gets the 3,000th base hit.
Well, Willie Mays will be, of course, at Candlestick Park this afternoon, and he will throw out the final pitch ever at the stick. That will be part of the big postgame ceremonies. Now, on April 11th of next season, the Giants will unveil Pacific Bell Park, and with over 26,000 season tickets already sold, Giants fans have shown that they are ready. And if you're one of the lucky ones to have a ticket, you are going to like what you see. It is looking more like a ballpark every week. As construction continues on Pacific Bell Park, the light towers now rise above the South of Market skyline, and you can start to see the unique elements of the park taking shape. The dramatic main entrance to the stadium, Willie Mays Plaza, is visible from the street. When it's completed, it will feature a bronze sculpture of number 24 to honor the Giants' greatest hero. But looking out from Pacific Bell Park is even more stunning than looking in at it. The right field wall, with its arches opening to the port walk and beyond to Willie McCovey Cove, is now in place. It is only a 307-foot shot down the right field line. That should be conducive to home runs and will give fans seated on top of the wall or standing behind it a great view of the action. Rows of seats will be installed during the next few weeks. When the CHW Giants pregame report continues, Val Diamond will light up this huge crowd with a stirring rendition of San Francisco. We will have that and much more when we come back to Candlestick Park.
amazing season without the A's. And their wild playoff run is right here on Fox Sportsnet Bay Area. Freeze, Stare, Giambi, Tejada, and the surprising staff continue their remarkable race for the pennant. You can't spell amazing season without the A's.
The A's win the game!
The A's face the Angels tonight at 7, only on Fox Sportsnet Bay Area.
This is not a range. This is the fiery precision and impeccable timing of doing the rumba with a very, very, very good dancer. The Dual Fuel Series with 13,000 BTU power burner, electric convection oven, warming drawer, a pulse racing pairing that raises a very unique kind of heat. Introducing Kenmore Elite.
For most of us, buying a new or used car is the second largest purchase we will ever make. It should be an enjoyable experience. One way to ensure that it is enjoyable is to buy from someone you trust. One of the best measures of trustworthiness is longevity. Only one Central Coast Auto dealership has been owned and operated by the same family for 76 years. Richardson Chevrolet, Salinas.
Richardson Chevrolet.
Being careful isn't enough. Accidents do happen and work injuries still occur. If you're hurt on the job, you need the certified specialists at Rucca, O'Boyle, Lombardo, and McKenna for expert legal advice. Don't wait until it's too late.
Making a false or fraudulent workers' compensation claim is a felony subject to up to 5 years in prison or a fine of up to $50,000 or double the value of the fraud, whichever is greater, or both imprisonment and fine.
From a beautiful garden walk to an elegant rock wall and wherever your designs may take you, Antolini Company provides a wide variety of masonry and landscaping supplies to help make those dreams come true. Over 30 years in business, we have the knowledge and experience to offer you the very best assistance possible in picking the right stone for you. But don't just take our word for it. Come and visit Antolini Company today and see for yourself. Antolini Company, where we're known for our stone.
Off the bottom of the 12th inning, sent the Dodgers home, at least into a tie, and the Giants went on to win the division. Welcome back, everybody. I hope you're enjoying this very special edition of the CHW Giants pregame report as we are closing in on first pitch in the final Giants game ever to be played here at the Stick. But right now, let's head upstairs to public address announcer Sherry Davis.
And now, to sing San Francisco, please welcome Val Diamond from Steve Silver's Beach Blanket Babylon, San Francisco's longest-running musical review, now celebrating its 25th year at San Francisco's Club Fugazi. Val Diamond.
San Francisco, open your golden gate. You let no stranger wait outside your door. San Francisco, here is your wandering one, saying I'll wander no more. Other places only make me love you best. Tell me of the heart of all golden west, San Francisco. Welcome me home again. I'm coming home to go.
All right, when we come back to the Stick, we'll check in again with KRON's Gary Radnich and also the national anthem from members of the Grateful Dead. All that and more, and of course, Giants baseball. Don't forget that. Giants and Dodgers coming up at 1 o'clock. This is the CHW Giants pregame report.
Now for a CHW sports tip.
Don't ignore pain above the heel that occurs with running, jumping, or rising on the toes. This is Achilles tendonitis, an inflammation or irritation of the big tendon in the back of the lower leg. Getting rid of the problem requires that you rest until pain-free, and then strengthen and stretch the attached calf muscles.
This health moment brought to you by the doctors and hospitals of CHW and their centers for sports medicine.
By the Bay on Fox Sportsnet. News Primetime is bringing the heat.
Take a deep breath.
The big names, all the games.
What a play!
You can't coach that.
Steve Sachs, Kevin Kennedy, and our starting lineup take you between the lines and into the zone.
And it is way out of here.
No bullpen, no championships.
The race for the pennant, complete coverage.
What a cannon.
You're out. Catch Fox Sports News Primetime, nightly at 10. Giants Pregame Report is brought to you by Catholic Healthcare West, the Bay Area leader in sports medicine.
And he hits one high to the left field and deep. Hollingsworth is back at the wall. And he got it! And this one is over! And the National League West is tied!
Is a moment that Giants fans will never forget. Of course, that home run tied up the National League West in September back in 1997. Giants went on to win that. Now joining me again is Gary Radnich. And Gary, you've seen more baseball games than I have here at the stick, but have you ever seen two better games back-to-back than those two Giant Dodger games in 97?
Yeah, it was a very hot time, Glenn, and I remember Brian Johnson vividly and how quickly fame can slip your fingers. We watched Brian grow up Oakland Skyline High, went to Stanford, quarterback on the football team, the toast to San Francisco, but the next year, there wasn't room for him on the Giant ball club, but indeed, that was some two games.
And you know what, that home run couldn't have happened to a nicer guy. Brian Johnson, no longer a Giant, but he's gonna live in the hearts of Giants fans for a long time, and you remember Brian, great guy.
He was terrific, Glenn, and I'm just thinking here, sitting in the Giant dugout, looking out on the field, my first memories, Bob Gibson as a Cardinal, Dave Parker strutting for the Pittsburgh Pirates. Unfortunately, I'm starting to sound like an old man on this show with you and Rod Brooks, but I go back to the 60s when you're a young man. You didn't have to worry about getting kids through college. You didn't worry about earning a living. You were just having fun. And boy, it's just like yesterday. Today's been great for me. I think I'm refreshed. I'm young again.
So we've been able to stir your memories a little bit. That's good.
Yeah, I appreciate you having me on the show, Glenn, and keep up the good work. And you know I'm a big fan. I don't know your brother who does the technical side, but I can listen to your brother Dwayne and Kruko talk about baseball, unfortunately, all day long. I should be helping my kids with their homework. Instead, I'm saying Kruko's got another story, and Glenn is setting his brother up for that story about he hit one home run. Hey, I'd love to hear him talk.
Hey, Gary, we can make you an honorary Kuiper brother if you want, but you may not want to do that.
There's not enough food at the dinner table with the three of you. No way.
All right, Gary, hey, thanks a lot. You've been great the last couple days. We appreciate it. Gary Radnich from KRON-TV and also KNBI Radio, and he has been a great help the last couple days. And, hey, everybody, it's getting to everybody. Candlestick, the final game ever to be played here. And, hey, if you look back, 40 years of Giants baseball, 40 years of baseball games being played here. And if you lived here your whole life, I haven't. But you can tell when you look around, there's people that are taking this day very, very seriously. And it's a meaningful day to those people. People have come out to Candlestick Park and froze when there's 8,000 people here on a Monday night against the Expos. But those people that survived those, They deserve to be here today, and I certainly hope most of them are. They're expecting a sellout crowd, maybe the biggest crowd to ever see a Giants game here at Candlestick Park. And with that attendance, the Giants will have the second best attendance they've ever had here in San Francisco this year. So that's all I got to say. It is a wonderful afternoon of baseball here at the Stick. But right now, it's time for the national anthem. Let's check in again with PA announcer Sherry Davis.
Presenting the colors today, the San Francisco Police Department Mounted Color Guard. And now it's time to welcome back some special friends of the Giants. They sang the national anthem for the first time publicly right here on opening day 1993. Please welcome three members of the Grateful Dead, Bill Lesh, Donna Jean Godshaw McKay, and Bob Weir, as they perform our Star Spangled Banner for one last time at Candlestick Park.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air. That our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Well, over 60,000 fans are set for baseball, and so are we. It's the Giants and the Dodgers coming up right here on Fox Sports Net Bay Area in the final Giants game ever at the Stick. For Rod Brooks and Gary Radnich, I'm Glenn Kuiper. I hope you enjoyed this edition of the CHW Giants pregame report. We'll be back after the game with all the postgame ceremonies from down here on the field. Right now, Dwayne Kuiper and Mike Kruger are standing by for the call of the game. Guys, take it away.
All right, thanks, Glenn, and of course I'm here with Mike Kruko, and I think, Mike, the neatest thing so far that we have seen is the fans, yes, are here to say goodbye, but they also the chant of Beat L.A. as we take a look at the Hall of Famer, Juan Marichal.
With all of the history that's walked through the Giants clubhouse before the game today, the Giants players have been caught up in it, and they want to win. This is not just to finish out the schedule.
Marichal throwing out the first pitch, and Marichal, along with many of the former Giants, are here today to celebrate the final game here at Candlestick Park. All right, remember, no tears yet. It's the Giants and the Dodgers, and that's just the way it should be to close it out. We'll have the starting lineups right after this.
Flying to Phoenix for business? If these 44 reasons don't convince you to fly Southwest Airlines to Phoenix, maybe this will. Call 1-800-IFLY-SWA.
You are now free to move about the country.
Hey, Jim,
Now listen, I got it right here, buddy. It's icy cold and tasting great. Now come on, Jeff, you tell me, is there anybody in this world who deserves this here Pepsi more than you?
Hi, Jeff.
See you later, Jeff.
Now that's what I call motivation.
I don't know where she came from.
The horses really don't like me. They think, oh, well, there's that darn truck. It's time to go to the barn. I don't want to be ridden today. It's not my fault. I don't ride them. I just take them where they need to go. They blame me. Can you believe? But luckily, my owner, he takes care of me. He knows my engine's made for a high-octane gas like Chevron Supreme with Tecron. And that Tecron, it helps keep my emissions low.
No premium outperforms Chevron Supreme with Tecron. Chevron, simply smarter.
My emissions are fine. The horse's emissions, they're questionable.
Different drummer. Dodge Intrepid. Well-equipped 19950.
Does this look like France to you?
Computer says we're over Paris.
But that's a yak.
Ashkata! Ashkata! Ashkata!
Didn't you check that computer up before you bought it?
No. Why?
Before you buy technology products, read the reviews on CNET.com.
Oh, look, there's the Eiffel Tower.
Giants Baseball is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, with fares so low, you have the freedom to go places. By Pepsi, the joy of cola. By the company you count on wherever life takes you. General Motors, people in motion. By Aflac, without it, no insurance is complete. By Heineken, it's all about the beer. Heineken. And by Chevron. To reduce knocking, try Chevron Supreme with the Tecron additive. Chevron, simply smart.
Well, what you're looking at is McCovey Cove. And that, of course, is what we will call it when we get to Pacific Bell Park over the right field wall. Here at Candlestick Park, it is a playoff World Series atmosphere. And what do you think is going through the mind of that guy?
Well, I tell you, of all the people here who has the biggest reason to be melancholy, it's Mike Murphy. Because he's got all of his boys back in town. Just a horde of ex-Giants players went through Mike's clubhouse today. Herman Franks, Roger Craig, Jim Barr, Hobie Landreth, Juan Marichal, Orlando Cepeda, Willie Mays, Dave Righetti, Chris Spire. And every time one came in, Murph teared up a bit.
Yep, and all you have to do with Murph to get rid of him is put a tape recorder in front of him or put a camera on Mike Murphy, and he is going to take a hike. And this was a day for Murph. It started very early this morning, and you could tell this was not a normal day for Mike Murphy. He was wound a little tight, and I think that Murph will be happy, as will everyone here, when this game gets underway and they throw the first pitch.
Well, it's been kind of a game of the Giants to try and get Murph to say he wants to go to the new ballpark. He has not said it yet, and I'm not sure he ever will. This is his home for 40 years.
Well, it opened on April 12, 1960, and that was obviously a very special day. 42,000 watched it as Richard Nixon, vice president at the time, said Sam Jones. All he did was throw a three-hitter. And Willie Mays started a 16-game hitting streak. Leon Wagner hit the first home run ever at the stick. Tell it goodbye, beat L.A., and I think really that's the theme. It's not just saying goodbye. It's the fact that the Giants are playing the Dodgers, and the fans reminded all of us of that about 10 minutes ago when the chant of beat L.A. just went from section to section. And that's what this game is all about. And you know the significance of this game. If all you have to do is look at the lineups. All right, it's the Dodgers and the Giants. And an absolute gorgeous day. We'll be back with more pregame festivities right after this.